The hour is sinking, all else continuing, the stars shining, the winds blowing, the nights, the notes of the bird continuous echoing, with angry moans the fierce old mother insists in moaning, on the sands of fallen up shore, gray and rustling, the yellow half-moon enlarged, sagging down, drooping, the face of the sea almost touching, the boy is static, with his bare feet the waves, with his hair the atmosphere dallying, the love in the heart long pent, now loose, now at last tumultuously bursting, the aria's meaning, the ears, the soul swiftly depositing, the strange tears down the cheeks coursing, the colloquy there, the trio, each uttering, the undertone, the savage old mother incessantly crying, to the boy's soul's questions solemn, kind, some drowned secret hissing to the outsetting bard of love. Demon or bird, said the boy's soul, is it indeed towards your mate you sing, or is it mostly to me? For I, that was a child, my tongue choose sleeping, now I have heard you, now in a moment I know what I am for, I awake, and already a thousand singers, a thousand songs, clearer, louder, and more sorrowful than yours, a thousand warbling echoes have started to life within you, never to die. Oh, you singer, solitary, singing by yourself, rejecting me. Oh, solitary me, listening, nevermore shall I cease perpetuating you, nevermore shall I escape, nevermore the reverberations, nevermore the cries of unsatisfied love be absent from me. Never again leave me to be the peaceful child I was before, what there in the night, by the sea, under the yellow and sagging moon, the messenger there aroused, the fire, the sweet hell within, the unknown want, the destiny of me. Oh, give me the clue, it lurks in the night here somewhere. Oh, if I am to have so much, let me have more. Oh, a word, oh, where's my destination? I fear it is henceforth chaos. Oh, how joys, dreads, convolutions, human shapes, and all shapes, spring as from graves around me. Oh, phantoms, you cover all the land and all the sea. Oh, I cannot see in the dimness whether you spy or frown upon me. Oh, vapor, a look, a word, a well-beloved. Oh, you dear women's and men's phantoms. Alert then, for I will conquer it. The word final, superior to all. Solo, sent up. What is it? I listen. Are you whispering it? And have been all the time, you sea waves? Is that it from your liquid rims and wet sands? Whereto answering the sea, delaying not, hurrying not, whispered through me the night, and very plainly before daybreak, lifts to me the low and delicious word, death. And again ever death. Ever death, 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 hissing melodious, neither like the bird, nor like my aroused child's heart, but edging near, as privately for me, rustling at my feet, creeping thence steadily up to my ears, and waving me softly all over, death, 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 which I do not forget, but fuse the song of my dusky demon and brother, that he sang to me in the moonlight on Palmanuk's gray beach, with a thousand responsive songs at random, my own songs awaked from that hour, and with them the key, the word up from the waves, the word of the sweetest song, and all songs, that strong and delicious word, which, creeping to my feet, the sea whispered.